Hello, good morning, and welcome to the 35th reenactment of the Great Battle of Britain. Here we are, sited outside Maidstone Castle. We believe this castle was in fact built by a Norman count, whose wife, we're not entirely sure, but believe she was partly Celtic and partly Viking. But of course, there's some discussion as to whether the Celts were in fact had any communication with the Viking race. We know that, for example, when the great invasions took place, when, for example, the Visigoths were walking across Europe in, well, it was probably about, well, just before 1400, but anyway, back to the contest. Here we are. We see, on the right, we have the VF-1F4. You can notice the tropical filter, for example, and the drop tank, an interesting innovation on this plane. The right ministry were somewhat reluctant to adopt this device, in fact, but anyway, that's enough of that. So on the other side, we see the Spitfire Mark 14, a very fine opponent for this German plane. It's been restored over a number of years. We believe, for example, that the wreckage of it was found on
depths of depravity that are being reached here, the interest of the... this is an obsessional hobby, you must understand. These planes have been carefully restored, and again, yes, Schmidt is still, yes, we're hearing, yes, we come from the station, yes, we're still holding the plane from the top of contact. Shuttleworth is completely confused by this, but he's completely confused. Yes, that's Shuttleworth doing a victory rally over the tower. He appears, Shuttleworth is obviously having trouble controlling the tower. This, in itself, could provide a new kind of problems in the closing stages of the contest. Absolutely extraordinary. My God, just narrowly grazed the hillside there. But this contest is so totally confusing, I feel I should tell you something more about Maidstone Castle. The entrance onto the nave at the front of the building is a very interesting specimen of 11th century Romanesque architecture. No sign of Schmidt. We believe he is somewhere near Carlisle. We believe he may well be following the line of the Great Roman Road, which was built in... we're not entirely sure. We believe that it was built in 123 AD, leading north, of course, from Chester to Carlisle, which was a vital strategic link for the Romans at that time. But anyway, so we'll leave Schmidt up there. We're not entirely sure what to do with him. Certainly the tropical camouflage on this aircraft will be of absolutely no use at all in the British countryside, because the strange mottled effect, olive green, dumped rather clumsily, I must say, at the last minute by the German team, on the wings of his aircraft, which of course are a delicate sand brown. This really won't be much good, and especially, for example, if he heads on north, because he's liable to fly over the tropical rainbow, the interesting little possible weapons for Britain's wonderful atomic energy program. But anyway, so there's Schmidt. Meanwhile, yes, it's Shuttleworth again. Obviously, it's completely cured. Very exciting, man. But it's surprising, really. I still have to keep on talking, because even though there's obviously one pilot left in the fight, this program has been sponsored by a number of extremely influential companies, and try not to keep on talking, the contest would be at an end, and I would have absolutely nothing to talk about, and as you can see, far be it from me to say that I'm improvising at this moment, but we know far be it from me. Anyway, let me tell you something about how to channel weapons, and I believe is great odds, that was severe misfortune in the Indian Mutiny, which, as you know, happened in 1857 in various areas in the Indian subcontinent, and which, of course, in turn has been a minor, which, of course, is of concern to us, owing to the very interesting dispositions of... I think this may well be, we seem to be suffering an extraordinary amount of interference here. I've been told by technical crewman, even as we speak, he is putting his best left leg forward. In fact, he's an interesting man, because I don't believe he does in fact have a right leg. No. This, in fact, has been confirmed. Short look at my crib sheet, and we see that he probably does have no right leg whatsoever. None at all. And the noise is getting incredibly
Hello, Home Office?
Just shut your filth up, Muffin. I will be over there to burn your house down and destroy your children. I'm going to beat your grandmother to death.
Gosh, that's awfully good. How about coming for an interview next week? Say, 4 o'clock Tuesday afternoon?
I'll come down there on Tuesday and destroy your house and beat your wife to death.
Splendid. I shall look forward to it with keen interest.
Right, bye.
Bye.